In this video, we're going to talk about the library function of Codebeamer. We're going to see how to configure it and the three main use cases, which are copying items from other projects, creating traceability, or creating cross-project traceability. Let's go to Codebeamer and see how to use it. Let's go ahead and pick one of the trackers. I'm going to use the customer requirement specifications. In the document view, on the right side pane, we're going to see the library button. Let's click on that. As you can see, there's nothing there right now because we need to configure it. So for that, let's click on this wheel icon. Here, we're going to see the list of projects that we have access to. So first, I'm going to select my current project, which is going to be the Codebeamer Automotive Template 3. And I'm also going to add another project from which I would like to copy my items from. So let's choose this one. If I click on Save, these two projects are going to appear on the right side. If I expand this, I'm going to see all of the different trackers and work items. As you can see, currently I'm taking a look at the Codebeamer Automotive Template 3.0, which is our current project. And by expanding the custom requirement specifications, we can see the same requirements on the right side as on the left side. But if I go to a different project, I'm going to see all those trackers that are available in the other project. So the requirements are going to be different. Let's take a look at the first scenario, where we're going to copy requirements from other projects. So let's say we'd like to reuse this requirement that says the vehicle shall be able to perform automated parallel parking. I can easily just click on it, drag it, and drop it onto my tree on the left side, so it's going to be part of my current custom requirement specifications. I'm going to make a copy of this item. We're going to get a warning that the following source fields will not be transferred because this is a field that is not existing in my current project, but it's not a problem. Now the items were copied successfully, so if I close this window, it's going to appear here in my customer requirements. If I go back to the properties on the right side, we're going to see that this item is copied and that there was an association created that this item is a copy of and the original item is associated here. As you could see, it's really easy to copy items from one project to another. Let's take a look at the second scenario where we're going to see how to create traceability using the library function of Codebeamer. So let's go back to the library. I'm going to close the other project because we're going to focus on the current project. In this scenario, we'd like to create traceability within the project. So on the right side, I have the current project in the library. So let's walk through the folders. We're looking for some test cases for our customer requirements, and we can find some in the validation tracker. Similarly to the copying, we can drag and drop the test cases to link to the requirements as a reference. So if I drop it here, we get the message that the reference was successfully created. I'm going to also put some more test cases there because it's not just a one-to-one connection. As you can see, I can do many test cases that are going to be appearing in the downstream references of the requirements. So now if I go back to the properties of my requirement, the downstream references are immediately visible and they are referred to the requirement where we place them. And for the Rust scenario, for the cross-project traceability, now I have two projects open. On the left side of the screen, we can see the Codebeamer Automotive Template projects, the one that we've been working on. And on the right side, we can see an additional project that is a different project but on the same instance. What I'd like to do is that I'd like to take a system requirement specification from one of the projects and refer it to my customer requirement specification in the other. Similarly to the library function, I can take this requirement, drag it, and drop it onto my customer requirement to create the reference. Once I left go with the mouse, the reference was successfully created. So I'm going to extend the left side of the project here, take a look at the properties of my customer requirement, and in the downstream references, we can see the system requirement associated to our customer requirement as a downstream reference. If I click on that, to see the details, I'm immediately navigated to the other project, the base demo template ADAS dataset project. Let's go to the traceability report to see how the traceability looks like. I'm going to configure my traceability report. So the initial filter is going to be the custom requirement specification. And for the first level, I'm going to add the system requirement specifications. If I hit go, we're going to see our newly copied customer requirement, but we don't see any system requirements assigned to it. The reason is that we are currently only filtering from our current project. So what I can do is that I select the other project where we have the cross-project reference. And from that other project, we're going to select the system requirement specifications tracker. So now this level is going to be a combination of two different projects and two different trackers. If I hit go now, we're going to see that now the referencing is showing up, because now we're also including the tracker items from the other project and the other system requirements tracker from that project.